sometimes we can generalize. There's two types of people that come to office.com. Those that want something right away. I need to know how this works. I need this shortcut. I need this template now. The other folks that come here are folks that are looking to get more information about how Office works. Maybe they are getting to a new job where they have to relearn Excel or learn Excel. They just got the new version of PowerPoint. They need to know what's new with that. And for that, we have Office training. This is some of the most successful, the content that customers like the best. Often people don't know we even have that, hence we wanted to do a webinar on that. Also, I'm in the room with a couple folks who are in the training program, so they put a gun to my head. So we want to talk about the Office training, some of the great stuff that we have here. We also have a guest who is a presenter and a trainer and a best-selling author about Office products, and she'll come on and talk about some of her things and some of her favorite tips to show you about how to work better with Office. So we will jump into that. First, let's go over and we're going to show office.com. And I'm going to show you how to get to the support site. So let's load up here. And we're going to, so this is office.com. And if you, at the top of the page is support. And this support site has many things. It has a lot of, some of the most popular stuff is called Getting Started. So for people who are, one, either just gotten an updated program, or maybe they've never opened up Project before or never opened up PowerPoint. They can get information about there. You can also find things about, make sure all your downloads and updates are up to date. If you have tech support with there's a thing called a product key troubleshooter. So if you're having trouble with your product key, there's some help we can offer that way. And then also there is this training area, and that's what we're going to do today, get free training. And again, all this content is free at office.com. So let me click on that and open that up. The short URL for this is office.com/training. And here, now because we just launched the new product, the new Office 365 Home Premium or Office 365 for Business, all the stuff here at the top of the page is mostly dealing with the new product because that's what people are coming here for. So you'll find things like First Words in Word 2013 or Calendar Basics and Outlook. If you scroll down here, you can look at by application what we have. We have a few for each already. We're still making training courses as we're going. Oh, look, there's a little thing about Office 15-minute webinars. You should tune that in sometime. But if you scroll down the page, you'll find more training for more versions of Office. Microsoft supports products for 10 years, so you'll find training for Office 2010, Office 2007. Let's just kind of dig into one of these pages. I'm going to click on Outlook and show you kind of the breadth of things that we have for Outlook. Anything from how to stay organized, how a calendar works, keyboard shortcuts. You'll find many different courses here in different levels. There's some stuff in here that gets into parts of Outlook. It's over my head. I can't, even though I was in one of these videos, I can't fathom some of the stuff with flagging and stuff like that. So you can start with the basics, you can go quite deep. And there's two ways to watch it. You can either, let's focus in on this one here, because this is actually the most popular course we have for Office 2010, using email signatures in Outlook. So there's two ways to view it. You can watch it, you can download it, and that way if you're online or offline a lot, you can download it once, and then if you're offline, you can go through it at your own pace, or you can just watch it online. I'm going to click that and kind of show you the start screen here. And each screen kind of gives you a little summary about the course, tells you how long this is, 25 to 35 minutes. And then there's videos here on the side. Now, this course only really has two videos, create email signatures and jazz up your signatures. You'll find usually there's more parts to it. Sometimes you'll find practice or tests, a quick reference card you can use for later. Now, I'm going to click on one of these, and let's just see. I don't know if you'll be able to hear this. If this works, you'll be able to hear the melodic tones of Colin Wilcox, one of our trainers and a teammate of ours. Let's see if this is going to work here. Let me.
Imagine you're switching from Outlook 2003 to Outlook 2010, and you need to know how to use email signatures in the new version. I'll show you how to use them from the ground up.
Okay, so that was Colin making a guest appearance here. So as you can see, it's done with the screenshots, with other tags and other notes so you can kind of see around the screen. And it goes through and you can pause the video, whatever you need to do. Let's go back here and look at a couple other training courses. And I want to show you some of the favorite ones here. So let me go back to training. And I'm going to click, and then I'm going to go into Word for 2013. looks like we have about 4 or 5 courses. So again, you can also watch these online or you can download if you want to. Just click on this download page. So this is one of the popular courses. This is the most popular course for the new 2013s with the new Office 365. This is Make the Switch to Word. As you can see, there's 5 videos of various lengths. This is the one you can download. You can click the other button to watch it online. Let me just show you some of the popular courses since that's what we talked about here. I'll switch over to a slide here really quick and then we'll get to our guest and be far more interesting than just me talking. So here's just a quick little card I put together of some of our more popular courses. Inserting a video into your presentation. That was new for PowerPoint 2010, so it makes sense it was one of the more popular ones. It also, we look at your rankings. I didn't show you on that page, but on articles, on videos, there's always a way to leave your feedback. And we look at that feedback to make sure the course is doing, the people think it's doing well. If it's not doing well, we're going to look at that course at some point and say, what are customers looking for? We look at your comments and your ratings for articles and videos in Office. So it makes sense also that a lot of the basic stuff is popular courses. How to create a basic chart in Excel 2010. Creating your first Word document in Word 2010. Again, we talked about email signatures and VLOOKUP. I mean, the Excel training is one that I actually use the most because I'm in Excel, but not regularly. So it's usually like, oh, wait a minute, this is something I could use VLOOKUP for. I should do that. So that's why you'll find things for pivot tables, for VLOOKUP there. And then the Make the Switch courses are easily the most popular right now for the new Office 2013. But enough about that. That's at office.com training. We can come back. We can show you some more of that at the bottom of the hour. Let's bring our guest online and have her talk about it. And this is Vicky Sokol-Evans of Red Cape Company. If everything works right, you'll be able to hear her now.
Hi, Doug. Hi, everyone. Yay, this was great. You know, I'm a huge fan of office.com, and that's where I get my training.
Excellent.
So I'm excited to see that, especially for the 2013 content. So that looks great, Doug.
Good. Red Cape Company is, again, you present, you've done keynotes. I just watched a video of you in London talking to folks, which was quite entertaining, and I learned stuff. So I'm learning from you. You're learning from us. We're learning from you. It's a circle of productivity life.
It's a vicious cycle, right?
So you've been doing this for about 15 years. How did you get started being this superpower person of office productivity?
Oh, I don't know about that. But just real quick, I was just thinking about how I became a trainer. And it happened 20 years ago when I was just 5 and I was a receptionist. And I'm obviously just kidding about the age 5, but don't do the math. I was a receptionist and an assistant and working in a typewriter and fax machine. And we used to do those paper memorandums.
Sure.
And then all of a sudden Word and Excel came into my life and I fell in love with it. Almost, I have an unhealthy relationship with the Office system and I'm definitely going to get it looked at.
Nobody in this room would think that's unhealthy.
I started automating my work using Excel and Word. And then people came to me asking for help, and so it was a natural transition for me to take on a role as a full-time trainer at a local technology training company here in Austin, where I taught the full day Excel and Access and PowerPoint classes back when we had that luxury of getting away from the office for a full day. So
we don't have that anymore,
right? Yeah. We can't get away. So that's why office.com and these great online tutorials is a great way to get that on-demand training now. So between then and now, I took several non-training positions at technology companies, but really I was missing the teaching component, and I had just a passion for improving productivity and helping other people, that I started my own training company, Red Cape, to help superhero assistants and entrepreneurs get more done in one day. So that's my story in a nutshell. Okay. Hopefully that was a nutshell, and yep. I'm very happy to be here and want to say shout out to all my Red Cape superheroes that are here. So thank y'all for coming.
Great. Thank you. Let's jump in. I'm going to switch over to Excel here, and we're going to give you some quick tips that one of the things that Vicky's a specialist is giving you 100 tips in 100 minutes. No, we're not going to do that, but right. We're going to do some real quick. And the first one we want to talk about is Excel tables and why using a table is worth the time. So this is going to be kind of interesting. She's going to be talking, but I'm going to be doing the demo. So let's go.
Yeah, so this is the feature I want to marry because I love it so much. And so this is just a basic list, and what we do is make it easier to work with. So on the ribbon, there's a big button, format as a table, and Doug is going to be my Vanna White today, and he's going to click format as a table. We don't want to worry about the colors. I know they're so pretty, but just pick the very first option for me, Doug, and it's going to convert this list as a table. We're going to say my table has headers, since it has headers in the list, and then click OK. And right out of the gate, some of the benefits that you'll see is, and it looks like there's a little delay.
Yeah. That's right. It'll work. But yeah, you'll be able to see everything's kind of in a band. There we go. Everything's in a band color. So it's, you're right. I mean, this is a 200 line list. This is, you'll be able to pick out names a lot easier. Looks like for some party that I'm not invited to.
Well, we're going to have to invite you now.
Okay.
So, yeah, and then at the top, you can see the drop-downs. I don't know if everyone can see the drop-downs. We automatically get this sorting and filtering option. And, you know, he could fill, you know, Doug, you can filter on Texas or any state there and find the attendees that are coming to the party.
Great. So, again, drop-downs you can add, but the table automatically puts them in there. So that's great.
Love it. And then if you want to expand the table, so if you add a new column, it's going to be added automatically to the format. And then the other thing I love is, like, when you scroll down in the table, look at the ABCs at the top, you know, the column headers say ABC. And when Doug scrolls down, the headers in that table are going to automatically pop into position. And then that way, you can sort and filter from any location in your table. So that's just great, yeah. from one click, that format as a table, we get so many benefits. And there's additional benefits, but we don't have time to show you today.
We're going
to
jump right into something else. I'm going to click over to PowerPoint. Mm-hmm. And we can come back. Again, if you're on the live call, we can look at some more things about tables in the bottom of the hour. But let's go over here, and we're going to click over to PowerPoint. Okay, so we're looking at a chart of retention rates. So if you're listening to us talk, you're only going to retain 5%, so we have to help that, don't we?
Yeah, and you can tell at the very bottom, you know, if we teach other people, we retain 90%. So a better way to view this slide is not in bullet format, but in a visual representation, a visual chart, or we're going to put this into a pyramid. So, Doug, would you do the honors and add some smart art to this slide?
Okay. So I'm going right up in the middle of the ribbon there and convert to smart art. And as I mouse over, I'm going to do this a couple times, each of these kind of shapes changes so I can see which one I want. And you said you wanted a pyramid, so let's go there and click that. Okay.
Awesome. And then you can add text for each one of those items. You can add some, well, you're going to do colors first and change the style. And these contextual tabs show up because he's clicking on Smart Art. So you get all of these great tools once you convert it to Smart Art.
Oops, that's not the color I want. I want that color. And then I click this layout, so I get them off there. And then even though you can add, so what we're going to do is we're going to add a little text here. So the lecture would be, you know, watch a webinar. And then we're going to type really quick and pull the cake out of the oven, because this was rehearsed, just so you know, we've done this once before. So let me show you what you can do. A couple minutes later, you can make a slide that looks like that. And this is something that you could definitely use. And this is a slide that people probably come up to you afterwards and say, hey, can I use that slide? And we'll want to give it to them, because then when you teach somebody, you'll actually remember about smart art and other things, right? That's what we're thinking, right? Okay, so that's SmartArt, and we're got time for one. We're going to go a little long, but let's go over to Word here and talk about styles.
Perfect. So this is a, what is it, 10,000?
10,000 word, 25-page employee handbook.
Yeah, so what we're going to do is format this instantly, like literally in seconds, by using styles, which have been around forever. And Doug is going to click in employee handbook and then apply the title style to the document. And we're less concerned about what it looks like, because he'll show you in a second how we can change the way it looks. And then he can add his heading, so that would be heading 1, and then he's got some heading 2s in there.
And then I can press one of our favorite keys is F4, repeats the last thing you just did, so I can just click on this line and then click F4, and it will change it. Now this is a heading 3, so I'm just going to change it. And again, don't worry about the color. Don't worry about, you can fix all that later. Let's just see how fast I can do this. Oops, I did that wrong. Come on. There we go. And I think that's the last one, F4. Okay, so there it is. And now on some screens, you may see this right next to the styles, a button about how to change it, but I'm gonna, on my computer, I need to go over here to design, and you'll find this document formatting, and let's just kind of browse, put my mouse over, and voila. Even though I haven't even clicked it yet, I just put my mouse on this, and we change the look of the document.
Yeah, all because we applied title and headings to this document, we're able to really just transform this into just a great-looking document.
And there's several, as you can, let me show that pull down again. There's several built-in styles, and you can even make your own styles, right?
Right, absolutely.
Okay,
yep,
so there's about 20 to change. And then if you like the style, but let's say your company color is not blue, you can change the colors instantly. So we'll go with green here. So again, great way to change at least the look of the document. Again, now I can, we kind of did this before, but you can see, you know, I can scroll down to page 25. Now, another thing with large documents that a lot of people have is the boss sees it and says, can you move this around? Can you move that around? And this is another place. This is the super duper thing that styles can do for you. So let me just show you. Okay, Doug, move this down here, this outside employment, and cut that, and then move it under here and put it there. And I'll do that. And oops, I styled it wrong. Mm-hmm. There's Doug doing silly stuff. So when you cut and paste one, you have to remember where everything is. You have to scroll through a large document, and you might have some errors in the way that you format it. But that's your cue.
Oh, for me. But click on your View tab and turn on your navigation pane, and you can, all of the headings in this document, headings 1, 2s, and 3s, will automatically fill in as little tabs on the left-hand side. And Doug, instead of dragging and dropping in the document, use your navigation pane to drag and drop any heading and its contents around, just like PowerPoint.
Yeah.
Like,
so here I'll take this this termination area and move that up, and that point and all the subpoints move up with it. So you can drag and drop everything this way and move it without even touching your document. And then what I also like is, as you scroll through the document, as you can see, let's see if you can see this on the screen here, I'm waiting for it to catch up a little bit. As I scroll through the document, the where I am on the page is actually color-coded, so I can see where I am on the document. A little tough to see that, just because we have extra video going on today because of our guests, so it's a little hard. But you can play around with this, again, using styles and then the navigation pane. You can, especially with large documents, open a large, if you're in a company with a large document, you can probably open and practice with this right away. Okay, so we're going to wrap up. We'll stick. Vicki, thank you very much. It's red. Let me get the title back up. We'll have all her links for information for her on our website. And you can go to aka.ms/Vicki. You're a short URL, Vicki. Have you ever been a short URL?
No, I've never been a short URL.
You now
so
are a
honored.
Short URL. Yes. Thank you. You're welcome. aka.ms/Vicki will get you the links for all the things we talked about today. Some of the things for Vicki at Red Cape Company, and also those 6 training courses we talked about. We'll also have the video up later this week. Any information about the Office webinar in general, aka.ms/offweb. And again, Vicki can be found at redcapeco.com. So if you're on the live call, hang around. We'll do some Q&A. Vicki, thank you for joining us on the Office 15-Minute Webinar.
Thank you, Doug. I appreciate it.
Next week, we'll be talking about the SkyDrive desktop app. There's a couple different ways to do SkyDrive. If you haven't known what the desktop app, it's beautiful. But for today's Office webinar team, thank you for joining this expanded version of the Office 15-Minute Webinar.